if they go enough for this character that's running all over the state, and we lose the state of Utah, that's devastating.
Devastating. That character that Donald Trump is referring to won't even identify him by name. It's Evan McMullen, an independent candidate who has a good chance of stealing Utah from the jaws of the Republicans and Democrats. And if he does, he could deprive Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton from an outright electoral victory, which would kick the entire presidential election to the House of Representatives. And then who knows what could happen. And guess who's here? It's independent presidential candidate and potential election spoiler, Evan McMullen. Welcome back, Evan.
Great to be with you, Kennedy. I don't think I'm a spoiler if we get it to the House. If we get it to the House, then we're the campaign of opportunity for this country to avoid Hillary Clinton and Donald
Evan,
Trump.
I respect and admire a lot of your views. I realize that much of what you believe in is pro-liberty, but that's nonsense. If it goes to the House of Representatives, they're not going to select you. And with all due respect.
So I guess we shouldn't even try because people like you want Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump to be president? Is that why?
No, dingbat. I've been talking for months about libertarian candidates and actually having
and
ideals
now endorsed,
in this
now
country.
They're endorsing Hillary Clinton. So where are they now?
Evan, so is that your play? Like, you honestly think that if you win in Utah, go ahead, run in Utah. I don't care if you get the six electoral votes.
We've been running around the entire country.
You weren't on my ballot. I didn't vote for you.
Well, guess what? We have a system that allows you to run as an independent.
Fine.
That's what I'm doing. You don't have to run through the two major parties to run for president,
true.
Kennedy.
That's our system. That's the Constitution. If you've ever watched the show, I have been talking about third-party candidates.
Well, I've been busy, Kennedy.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry I haven't caught the show. But,
okay, well, then please don't make assumptions about my views and who I'm voting for. Go ahead.
Okay, do you have a question?
I have a lot of questions.
All right,
do you enjoy being in the position where you could tip the scales away from both major party candidates?
I don't know if I enjoy it. I don't know that I enjoy this at all. I'm stepping into this race because I believe the American people deserve a better option than Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. Is it hard? Is it a long shot? Absolutely, yes. If the race gets tight, and it looks like it is tightening, then we have an opportunity to block them both. I wish that somebody would have gotten into this race much earlier than me. I wish that Mitt Romney or somebody else had done it. In the end, they took a pass, and so I felt that someone needed to do it, and if no one else would, I decided to go forward.
Mitt Romney probably would have won Utah, but he's an also-ran. He would not have won a general election. You and I both know that, but I want to talk to you about...
It doesn't have to be him. It could have been anybody. I would have supported, you know, a range of people. I mean, Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump...
Could have been David French.
Could have been. But Donald Trump and Hillary Clinton both want, and I think you and I, Kennedy, agree on this, they both want to expand the size of government.
I agree. No,
I, That's
and there,
good
there
for
are
us.
Things in your platform that I agree with, and I know that you have made a pitch to libertarians. But I think where you diverge from libertarians and you meld better with conservatives is on drugs and war. You are much more of a pro-war candidate than ideological libertarian.
Look, Kennedy, I'm sorry. I got to push back there. I've said that I thought the Iraq war was a mistake. I've also served in war, and I know how terrible it is and know that we need to avoid it at all costs. But I'm not the kind of person who's going to say that we're not going to be willing to fight when we need to fight. And that's just a silly thing for a leader to say. So I'm out there saying that Iraq was a mistake, and so the idea that I'm some kind of war proponent is just silly, especially
somebody who served
in multiple wars.
Yeah, would you legalize drugs?
I believe that states ought to be able to make the decision for themselves.
So heroin? Can heroin be legal?
I think states should be able to make that decision. I think that would be a really bad decision. I wouldn't support it. I wouldn't vote for
it. Would you reschedule marijuana on day one in the Oval Office?
I don't know if I do it on day one, but I do
support
rescheduling it. Yes.
First 100 days.
Perhaps.
All right. How do you predict?
I'd be focused on getting this economy open to everybody, getting it up and running, reforming our government so there isn't so much power in Washington, securing our country.
Okay.
That would be the sort of thing I would focus on the first
Evan,
100 days.
We unfortunately have to go, but I want to ask you, how do you think this thing is going to end? Who's going to be our next president? Honestly, what do you think?
I think it's going to be one of two scenarios on November 8th. Either, unfortunately, Hillary Clinton is going to win in a landslide. That's where the polls have been for some weeks.
Mm-hmm.
Or it's going to be a very close race. Donald Trump, if he wins, it's not going to be a landslide. So it's either Hillary Clinton in a landslide or a close race. If it's a close race, we can block them both and keep hope alive that we can get a better option than Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump in the White House.
Evan, thanks for coming by. I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Okay, cool.